Brady. We're working on some brand new construction. We're putting in tamper-resistant outlets in the bedroom because it's where children will be sleeping, and there's a possibility of kids putting keys into an outlet. So here in the country I was born in, we use 14 American wire gauge on 15 amps, 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps. In this case here, we'll be finding that the black is live, the white is neutral, and the bare and the green is the ground. So I'll show you how to install these tamper-resistant outlets. Okay, so here's our product. That was really short. Okay, so we'll fix our loops, the direction that our screw turns. Make our loops nice and big so we can fix them so that when we close our loops, our insulation's not too close or too far from the device. I'm gonna go a little off, this one's a little long. So these are they come packaged like this, they don't get dusty inside. And these look like they're pretty well made. See how they're snapped together here on the back? So they have more durability, plus the rivet in the middle. So we'll start with putting our white wires on the silver screws here. Tight.
I'm gonna use my flathead because my Phillips is going bad. And once I screw this in, I'll show you the advantage of having the tamper-resistant outlet. They are nice to have in, like, kids' bedrooms and nurseries. Make sure they're tight. Okay, and our ground is down here. It's short, so I'll make our loop the direction that the screw turns here. I'll try to get around the loop this way. It's kind of short. Alright, there it is. It's the best it can be. It is around 2/3 of the way of the screw, or 3/4 of the way around the screw, and the copper is under the screw head all the way around. So we are going to have to put an outlet spacer on this one, so I'm not going to screw it all the way down. And these take the decor covers and they just go on like that, and we'll put our two screws go right there. So the advantage of the tamper resistant outlet is see how a child can take a key and stick it into an outlet like that. And if they touch something live, if they touch it on the live side and touch something grounded, they could get a shock. But this one, the tamper resistant, has shutters on it, so you can't put something in it. You have to push a plug in that pushes on both of them at the same time to make it open. That's the advantage of the tamper resistant outlet. So we'll go and put our second one in. Thank you. these wires are put around the screw the right direction. Now look how sloppy this one is. They put the wire around the screw backwards on that one. And they put the ground wire around the screw backwards also. Okay, so flip this around so it goes around our screw in the direction that the screw turns. Okay. Sure it's tight and our copper's under the screw head. I'll open this up a little bit more, make her look a little smaller. The direction that the screw turns here. There it is, nice and tight. Oops, our copper's not quite under the head here, so I'm gonna open this up again here. Pull it back. And underneath here, squeeze it in, pull back. Make sure it's tight. Now it is under the screw head all the way like we want it. Okay, now we'll get our ground wire on our green screw here. Okay, there it is. And now we'll rotate this around so we get our black wire. We gotta get our ground wire down here at the bottom. Okay, we'll flip this around so our wire goes going around the screw the direction that our screw turns. We're going to clip a little off because that loop is kind of big. Bring it around, take a little more off of that. There we go. Those are good. Tighten our screw here. There it is, that's what we want. I'm going to make this loop a little bit smaller because it's a little too big. Close our loop the direction of our screw turns. Make sure it's tight. Our copper's under the screw head all the way around. Then it pushes into our box, keeping our ground wire down away from everything here. Okay, we'll have to put an outlet spacer on the bottom. But the top is nice and flush. Oh, look at all that copper they left behind there. That's no good. And see how sloppy that connection is? Let's look over here. They got the wires around the screw the right way here, but the wrong way here, and a lot of copper here. Okay, so we'll see how this comes out. They do have a crimp sleeve on the ground wire, so it's up to code. So we'll fix our loops here. This one is way too big. And we'll open it up. We'll clip some off. Make our loop the direction that our screw is going to turn. This one will open up. This one was way too big, so we'll cut quite a bit off of this one and keep this one on here.
Good.
Good, good. That first one needs a couple outlet spacers, but they just snap in underneath the screws. You don't have to unscrew them. Save them.
Yeah. Boy, all four screws are missing out of this one?
I unscrewed, took them out to make it easier to take the wires off.
Okay. This is the light switch that's for here.
Yeah. Boy, I found a lot of sloppy work they did in here.
I imagine. Dave, do you have, where's all the outlet covers?
Oh, they're right here. I'm going to put them all in that window sill. How late are you going to be here?
Pretty much all day.
Oh, like Dan takes me and I come back around 4:30 or so, would you still be here?
Just shoot me a message.
Okay, because I was going to leave my phone and recharge it if I was going to do the fans when I come back. Yeah, mine is Type-C, but I brought a Type-C rapid charger.
That's what I have.
Oh, okay, so I'll put it on yours, because mine's only a 2.5 amp. Good. Okay, so we'll get our first two white wires on the silver screw here. Okay, there's our whites. Okay, we'll get our ground wire over on the green screw. There it is. Okay, now we'll get our blacks hooked up. Okay, this one's a little long, so I'll clip a little off of this here. Okay, you've got to bring that back a little bit. Let's see how the insulation... Oh, no, the insulation's not going to get under the screw head, so I'm just not going to... I'll just make sure it's back far enough here. Insulation's just right up to the bottom of the screw head. See, I hate these Phillips screwdrivers. These green screws rip them apart. Okay, the insulation is just right up to the bottom of the screw head. Okay, so I'll straighten this one out. Okay, I'll just clip a little off of this one. Make our loop the direction that our screw is going to turn here. There we go. I'll make sure that ground wire is away from our terminals here. See how that ground wire was close to the terminals up here? Brought too much jacket into this box here. Score it down the middle here. There we go.
Hey, we got power off all downstairs too.
Oh, everything is off downstairs?
Well, not everything, but...
Oh. So I'm almost done with this room. I just have one more outlet there. This one, they brought the jacket way into the box, way too far.
Huh. Holy Christ, I guess so. Wow. That's quite a ways out.
Yes, it is.
It's about 4 inches too far out.
Yes, it is. And I've
seen that would explain why that outlet was so hard to get in. Or would have been hard to get in, I mean.
Yeah. Okay, now we can get this back in.
Now, Dave, when you come out of this room,
yeah,
you might as well hit this hallway.
The hall? Okay.
And work your way back.
Oh, okay. I was going to do the other two bedrooms in the hallway.
Oh, you can do that too. Doesn't matter.
Yeah. Fold this bare wire over the probe scope there. Okay. So, that snow wasn't as bad as they said it was going to be, wasn't it?
No, not by any means. Not bad at all.
Uh-huh.
Compared to what they said it was going to be.
Yeah. Because Onondaga County had a warning for, I think it was 9 to 15 inches.
Yeah, we didn't get anywhere near that.
Bring the soup up a little bit further so that the insulation comes up closer to the bottom of the screw head here. Okay, there we go. Wires are all around the screw, the direction that the screw turns. Twist our black wire so it's not wrapped around the ground here. Just keep our ground wire down at the bottom here. Keep our ground wire down at the bottom there. There's our black wires. Looks like somebody stripped this with a pocket knife, so I'm gonna clean that up a little bit there. Now we have a nice clean strip. I'll put this off a little bit. Those are looped the direction that the screw turns. There we go, that's what we want. Staying down away from everything here. It's tight. The ground wire is down away from everything. Oh wow, look at the sloppy connection here. That wire is not even under the screw. See how that's all up over the screw head there, and there's even a gap there. Look, when they stripped this wire, see the bare spot here? They actually nicked the copper right there. See the bare wire right here? It actually broke right off. That wire wasn't even any good. Same with this one here. You can see the bare copper right there. Slack here, just barely. I'll score it down the middle here. And they even nicked the white wire a little bit too, you can see right there. They do have a crimp sleeve on the ground wires, so just twist these up here. Wow, the ground wire broke. Guess what? I found broken wires when I pulled it out. The cut wire, the black and the white, were both cut.
Huh.
Do we have any 12-2 downstairs to make a pigtail?
In the garage, I believe they.
Strip the insulation off this black wire here to make our tail for the ground wire. So what'd you do yesterday? Because I have a little bit of a stuffy throat. Weren't touching. You know those wire strippers that you can strip the Romex with? The outer jacket?
Yeah.
That's what they used.
Yeah.
and they must have went at a little bit of an angle and nicked the outsides. So the ground wire is in the middle.
Yeah.
So it didn't touch. Oh, I saw Bob Crello yesterday.
Where?
Up at Price Chopper.
Oh, he's back in New York?
Yeah, he had a relative die, so he came back up for the funeral. He's doing pretty good. He might buy a house in Florida and have me fly down and do some wiring.
There you go.
That'll be a lot of fun. There you go. More light on the silver screws. Have you noticed how the green screws rip your Phillips screwdrivers apart on the outlets and switches?
Sometimes, yeah.
Some of these loops are way too big, and it's tight and our insulation's not under the screw head. So how much are these outlets a piece online?
I don't remember, Dave.
They look like they're pretty decent quality too.
Oh yeah, I buy the cheapest ones. Thank you. Dave.
Yeah.
Can you give me that right now,
room?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, because usually the ones I buy are so soft.
Yeah, this is a stiff bristle.
Oh. Oh, that's what it's called, a stiff bristle?
Yeah, stiff.
Yeah. Where'd you get it?
I remember, honestly. I might say a little bit, that could be wrong.
Oh. Okay, we'll have to put an outlet spacer under here, but this one will be good. Wow, look at all the excess copper they have there, so we'll have to clip that back soon. You got this one around the screw backwards. Brian,
yeah.
I want to show you something.
What?
I want to show you something here.
Okay.
You can see the bare spot in the white wire where it comes out of the jacket.
Yeah.
Well, we had a nice pleasant surprise. We have no electrical tape, so we will strip this back, and we'll just come back to it and tape it later. So I'll open this up enough so that if you don't have it, you don't have it, and if you can't do it, you can't do it right now, but we will later. Let's see if the black is cut, no? Thank you. Okay, so I'm going to hook our outlet up, and we're going to leave our problem behind until later when we get some tape. So I stripped it back so we can tape it. Okay. This way to keep it from wrapping around the screw as I tighten it. Make sure it's tight. And our copper's under the screw head all the way around. Good.
Alright.
Yeah, I just hope we don't have that problem in almost all of them, because I have a feeling that's what they use, those type of strippers.
Okay.
Yeah.
But
you'll be fine. Make sure it's nice and tight. And I brought the jacket back.
Now, did you put that light switch in the
no.
master bedroom?
Yeah, I'll do the switches next.
Okay, so you do all the outlets and switches?
Yeah. Okay. look at the sloppy work here. Yep, same problem in this box, Brian.
What?
Same problem in this one.
What?
Same thing in this one.
Hey, just do what you gotta do, what?
Okay.
What's wrong?
This one's really short.
Let me see, Dave.
Okay.
Where?
Right there, the black and the white.
It's fine, Dave.
Oh, okay.
It's fine. I can't see it stopping, this stuff sets up.
We're just gonna put this one together because I don't think that cuts all the way through. Insulation's going right up to the bottom of the screw head there. Oh, okay, that loop's too big, so... Make sure it's tight, and our insulation's up to the screw head. Make sure it's tight. This is work somebody else put in, not what I put in. That makes it harder. Well, look at all the jacket they brought in on this box. See the sloppy work putting the wires around the screws? I got the wire around the screw backwards on that one. That screw wasn't even tight. Thank you. Oh, where they stripped that one. See the bare copper there? Again with this one, see the bare copper here that was left on there, right there. They didn't cut into the white. Okay, I'll twist our bond wires up here. I'll leave them in that crimp sleeve. Okay, we'll put our ground on it. Green screw here. Yeah. Okay, here, black is on the brass. Maybe I'll look the direction of the screw turns. Okay, so we got this in here. Push our ground over down, make sure it's down. Well, I got that one around the screw backwards here. Oh no, that's right. Got a sloppy connection. This one's around the screw the right way. Okay, so we'll close the screws you're not going to be using. Okay, so we'll open our loops up again here. A little off this one, but it's too long. This loop's a little bit too big, so I'll just take a little bit off of this here. works. Boy, put our lap over here on the brass guard screw. Well, I'll put a spacer down here. They did a nice job hooking this one up on the black side anyway. And the white was good. Okay, we'll close the screws that I'm using here. Okay, we'll put our green wire on the green screw here. It's tight. Put the ground wire down away from everything. Okay, so let's get these wires. This one they did a better job on. Good, good. When I finish the bedrooms, if my battery is kind of low, I'm going to put my phone on the charger and take a break, go get something to eat.
Okay.
These loops are kind of big here, so I'm going to make them a little smaller. Okay, we'll put our ground wire together here. They strip these outer jackets differently in here, so we don't have that problem. Did you see the open mic that I sent you a picture of?
What's that?
The open mic that I was in telling jokes.
I did not.
Oh. I told a joke in an open mic, and it got lots of likes.
Did you send it to me?
Yeah, I did. It was at Bella Vita.
I haven't seen it yet.
Well, the joke was, is my teacher told me to come up to the chalkboard and write a sentence.
Yes, I did. Yeah, that's pretty fun. Yeah.
Okay, that's what we want. Our insulation just comes up to the bottom of that screw head there. We'll put an outlet spacer behind this one. Oh, this one's around the screw backwards up here. Always put your wire around the screw the direction that the screw turns. See, both of these were around the screw backwards. But they got the white ones around the screw the right direction. All these outlets did have the ground wire crimp sleeve in them like they were supposed to, so that was a good thing. So I needed to go and make tails or put crimp sleeves on all the ground wires. Alrighty. Make sure it's tight. Now we're going to flip these loops so that the wires are going around the screw the right direction here. Make sure it's tight. Okay, I'll make sure ground wire's not touching anything yet. You know, I think I put a couple outlet spacers on this one, so I'm not gonna screw this in all the way. These were around the screw backwards here. Thank you. They did a sloppy job. They don't have the wire under the screw head all the way around there. Okay, so we're gonna ground wire on the green screw here. Okay, there it is, nice and tight. Okay, we're going to swing these loops around so that they're going around the screw the right direction here. Okay. Make sure it's tight. I'm gonna make it flip a little bit different here so that it's not too big. A little bit off of this here, it's a little long. There we go. Close our loop. Okay, now we'll just get a wall and keep that ground wire down away from everything here. Staying down away from everything. Good. So if we do that job up there in, where is it, Boonville? This is how fast?
Old Forge.
Old Forge, okay.
I got to see if I still got the job. I've been held up at Amy Andrews.
Oh, okay. I'd go just as fast as I am here. When I go to Walmart, do you want me to get some electrical tape? Do you want me to get some electrical tape at Walmart?
No, I got electrical
tape. Oh, you do? Okay.
I told you it was
something wrong. Oh, okay. Oh, this one is a mess. Three wires in this one. Yep, I'm gonna need a short piece of 12-2 to make a tail for an outlet in here because there's a... Okay.
I told you that.
Okay. Okay.
For which outlet?
This one, because there's three blacks and three whites.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Let's go in the garage. Wherever you put the keys, I already know what key it is
to
the garage.
Okay. You gave me the back door key.
Dave, I gave you the whole keychain.
Oh, okay. Oh, wait a minute, this has four wires in it. You know what, I don't think an outlet will even fit in this box with...
They had an outlet in it, it fits in it. Yeah. You just took an outlet out of there, how could an outlet not fit in there?
Because when I put the wire nuts in, because these were backstab, two wires were backstab.
Okay, well then do that on the new one.
Oh, you can't backstab on the new ones, because you can only put 14 in the hole. Not up to 12.
Do what?
You can't put number 12 in the hole on the new outlets.
Why can't you? I've done it before.
Because they're only made for 14.
Dave, that makes no sense. Let me see when the new outlets.
Okay.
I don't know why you keep thinking that it's okay to run.
Backstab this one.
Is it
already? It's not going in. second.
Did you do it the way that I showed you?
Yeah.
It'll go in there. You want me to do it?
Yeah. Yes.
Move your camera back so I can see what I'm doing. I'm locked in so I get out of the room.
Oh, okay.
Which one are you on?
The two blacks.
I had one black in. So you're on this one?
Yep.
The wire's probably too long, Dave. How long was the wire?
It was good, about half an inch or more.
Half inch or more?
Yeah.
That's almost a whole inch. You don't need that much in the box. That's probably why it's not going in. And it's not straight, so that's not going to help. Are you recording me?
Yeah, I'll pause.
Well, I can't concentrate.
So what we're going to do is pigtail all these wires here.
Same length here. Too big of a crazy twist here because I got five wires here. Unfortunately, I was even lucky to get them all even at the end there. I'm going to put a little so it's perfectly even here. Started here as the first two. Open these up. So I'll even with the shortest one now. Holding this tail so it doesn't get wrapped around and uneven on the side of the wire knot. Okay. So we have a wire that's just twisted and it's not in the wire nut in the crimp sleeve there for the ground. So we'll open this up. Yeah, I'll do that one later. it off so it's even with the shortest one here. What?
Why are you doing that one later?
Oh, because I have to reposition the wire so I can fold it in the box easily. So I'll do that one off camera when I'm all done with this one.
Okay. Dave, you all the screws out of all of these?
What? They can be thrown off.
I didn't want to throw them.
Oh, okay, then we can save them then.
Well, no, all the screws are out of the floor, so... No sense in that now, it's
Okay, now we can put our device back in.
Oh,
okay, I can put the screws back
in. Hey, this is not the end of the world. I got 100 of them.
Oh.
The light switches don't good because I want to keep that.
Oh, okay. Okay, go. I'll flip our ground back a little bit here. Ground wire goes on the green screw here. Okay, the white goes on the silver colored screw, the direction that our screw turns. Make sure insulation's not getting under the screw head there. Make sure it's tight. Okay, I'll make my loop the direction that the screw turns. Make sure it's tight. The insulation got up kind of close, so I'll loosen this up. I'll bring it back. I'll bend it over like that to keep it from wrapping around. But I'm gonna have to bring this wire back out a little bit. Okay, our insulation's not getting under the screw head. We're good. We'll keep our ground wire down at the bottom here. Pushes some air blocks. So you can see the letters TR, that's how to tell that an outlet is tamper resistant. Okay, now we'll use our electrical tape here, and we're back at this outlet where the wires got cut. Cut a little piece. This is a good high quality 3M tape. So we'll put it right over the cut mark here. There's one. This is gonna be two. I come up, I get on a little bit over here so that it sticks together so it doesn't come off. I'll just wrap it around there. Okay, now we have this one up here, right here. Okay. I let the tape stick to itself a little bit, so if it starts to unwind, it won't come off. Alrighty, now we can put this into the box. Push my down wire down, make sure it's down away from everything here.
Dave, I got all the outlet covers, I'm putting them in the window.
Okay, good.
Alrighty, so that is how to install tamper-resistant outlets and repair some issues that was in the wall before with the wiring that was there that the previous electrician did probably maybe 2 or 3 years ago. Peace. Thanks for watching. Okay.